with it.
James Rogers joins me, an expert in European geopolitics and Baltic security. James, very good evening to you. I've read the full investigation. I imagine you have too. I found it very convincing, but of course the Russians aren't buying it.
No, of course they wouldn't, and they have a kind of track record in doing this as part of their broader attempt to stoke misinformation and spread lies and to stir up trouble in Western countries, which they wish to dislocate and break down so that they are unable to prevent Russia from doing things that it wants to do, mainly in its own near abroad and also in Russia itself.
So what happens now? Because the Russians are not suddenly going to hold their hands up and say, yeah, OK, fair cop, it was us, Gov. That they are still going to deny it. What options are there now for Britain to take?
Well, there are a range of options. One of the options that Britain has taken is to try and garner greater international support and to draw attention to the fact of what Russia has done, and to try and create as broad a possible international coalition, including European countries, North American countries, the United States, even Japan, Australia, and to try and draw attention to the fact that Russia is actually now engaged in revisionist behaviour and also in behaviour that's actually harming people in Western countries. And that is one of the primary ways in which the UK has done that. Other ways might include a kind of horizontal escalation by probing Russia in areas where it's also very vulnerable. For example, in Ukraine, the British Defence Secretary recently announced that more troops would be sent there from the UK to help with training missions. The UK could also help additional allies in other parts of Europe as well, such as the Baltic states, where it has a very strong military presence through NATO. So there are a range of different options, and also, of course, drawing attention to what Russia is actually doing and calling it out loudly when it actually undertakes this kind of wild and unruly behaviour.
But in the end, a lot of people are still going to believe the Russian version of events. So we're going to be talking about this on the programme after 8 in more detail, and I can guarantee that we'll be getting calls from people saying, oh, well, this is just, this website is not to be trusted, never heard of it, and all the rest of it. How can we be reasonably sure that their investigation actually is true, it's an independent investigation, and wasn't influenced by any British government sources?
Well, I think we just need to look at the character of the Russian regime and the way in which it is mounted increasingly belligerent and aggressive operations against European and Western countries since the middle of the 2000s. So we've seen an increase in revisionist behaviour, whether it's in Georgia in 2008 or Ukraine in 2014, or stoking up frozen conflicts in Moldova and in the Caucasus. Also, the use of cyber attacks on NATO countries such as Estonia and so on and so forth. And there's a general movement of using misinformation and forms of disinformation and basically spreading lies to try and break down the confidence that Europeans and North Americans have in their own democracies. And I think we just need to constantly be aware of that and continue to call it out when it's actually happening, which is increasingly all the time now.
James, thank you very much. That's James Rogers.